Hi everyone, in this video we're going to look at how Ivanti Neurons Patch for Intune greatly simplifies deploying and patching third-party applications with Intune. Not only can you patch third-party applications from the Ivanti supported products catalog, you can also add and manage new custom applications, all from within Ivanti Neurons. Let's see how. Although you can add custom applications to Intune, this involves downloading and using the Intune package generator to package the MSIs and exes required, as Intune cannot deploy these file types directly, and then configuring the deployment separately. With Patch for Intune, however, this packaging is automatically handled for you. This means you have a single application for all of your Intune patch management, from packaging the installers through to managing their deployment. Using Patch for Intune, you create a custom application definition that specifies the installer binaries to use, the installation prerequisites to check for, how to detect that the installation has succeeded, and finally, the installation command to run. Patch for Intune then takes this information and creates the required Intune packages for you from the binaries you supplied, and provides all the same management options for the new application as for any other application you manage through Patch for Intune. Let's give it a go. In Patch for Intune, on the Products tab, click Create Custom App. The Create a Custom Application panel appears. Enter a name. This must be unique and is the value that will appear in both Patch for Intune and in the company portal. And then enter the vendor and version. Now, we can add the required installers. Click Add Installer. The Add Custom Application Installer dialog appears. Click Upload and browse to and select the installer files you require. The files are uploaded and virus checked. Select the device architecture. One thing to be aware of is that although you can create separate products for different architectures, x86, x84 or both, it is more efficient to create a single product and add multiple installers for it. Click Next. The first configuration step is to specify the rules that determine whether an application can be installed. Click Add Detection. A menu appears, enabling you to select from four different detection methods. I'm not going to describe all of the options here because there are very many. The options available are those that are available in Intune. There's a link in the help to a page that describes all the options. In broad terms, the types of detection you can set enable you to test the properties of a path and file name, including using environment variables in the path, the properties of an MSI product code, the value of a registry key path and value name, or the value of the output of a PowerShell script. When you have configured the requirements, click Next. This section enables you to specify how to determine that the application has been successfully installed. You must include at least one detection method, or Intune cannot detect that the application installed successfully and will keep trying to install it. The detection options are almost identical to the requirements section, and for the application to be detected as installed, all the detection conditions you specify must be met. Next, you set the install and uninstall commands. In install command, enter the installation command, including any switches that you want to run to install the application. Similarly, in uninstall command, enter the uninstallation command. Note that this field is mandatory, as it is in Intune, even if your application has no uninstall command available, although no one insists on the command actually working. Set how long you want the system to wait for the installation to complete, and specify whether or not you want to offer the uninstall option in the company portal. Of course, select this only if the uninstall will actually work. Select how you want to handle reboots for the installation. You can configure restarts depending on return codes coming from the application's installer, or let the application install force a restart if it requires one, suppress restarts, or configure Intune to force a restart when the installation completes. Click Next to review your configuration, then click Add Installer. The Add Custom Application Installer dialog closes and the new installer appears on the Create a Custom Application panel, from where you can edit or delete it. If required, you can add another installer for the application. For example, you may need to add another installer to provide both an x86 and x64 version. When you have added the required installers for a product, click Save. The product is added to the products grid, where it can be managed in the same way as other products in Patch for Intune. No need for any separate packaging like there is when using Intune directly. That is all handled for you automatically. The Custom Applications tile on the Products tab shows all the custom applications in your system, along with all the standard configuration options available to you, including adding an icon or managing the deployment. You can also edit, clone, or delete the application from Neurons. Cloning provides a convenient starting point for creating a new version. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and remember to subscribe to our channel to see more videos like this about all of our products. Thanks for watching.